Hi, my name is Margaret Smith, and I am the Orange County 4-H Animal Science Program Manager, and we're about to start our journey for incubation and embryology. But before we get started, I'd like to introduce a special guest today.
Hi, my name is Frank Smith. I am a part of 4-H Truth Seekers.
Awesome, Frank. Are you ready to learn about incubation embryology?
Yep.
All right, here we go.
Hey, so welcome to our first episode of 4-H Incubation and Embryology. So what does that mean? Incubation is maintaining controlled environment conditions for the purpose of favoring growth or development. What does embryology mean? Embryology is a branch of biology and medicine that studies embryos and how they develop. So when we're learning about incubation embryology, we're focusing on ducks and chickens. So before we start every single class, we're going to go over our rules. Rule number one with incubation and embryology is do nothing. And rule number two is if you have to do something, wash your hands. We're going to make sure we go over our checklist every time we go near our incubators. Have we washed our hands? Do we make sure that our incubator is working? Have we added our water? And is the temperature 99.5 to 100? If all of those things have happened, then we're ready to start class. So let's begin with our eggs. Only fertile eggs will hatch. So what does that mean? Fertile eggs come from a special farm called a breeder farm where roosters and hens live together. But the eggs that we buy in a grocery store are grown at hen-only farms. And they are not fertile, so they will not hatch if you put them in an incubator. So incubator, let's look at our incubator. What does our incubator do? An incubator maintains a safe environment for hatching. It replaces the hen. It must be checked daily. It rotates our eggs at a 3-degree angle every 45 minutes. You only have to add water every 2 days. The ventilation, it allows for clean air to flow in and out, and it keeps our humidity where it needs to be so our eggs can develop properly. So when we're talking about our incubator for our chickens and our ducks, they're going to differ. Our chickens are going to incubate for 21 days, and our ducks are going to take around 28. So what breeds of chickens and ducks are we incubating? The Pekin duck is a breed of domestic duck raised primarily for meat. The males weigh around 10 pounds and females weigh around 9. The speckled Sussex is a British breed of dual-purpose chicken, so they are reared for both meat and eggs. Their egg colors are brown, cream, and tan with speckles. The black Austral, breed of Australian origin, developed as a utility breed with focuses on eggs laying, and the egg color is brown. Yokohama, a German breed of fancy chicken with unusual coloring and very long tail feathers. The eggs are colored tinted white. A Buff Orpington, it's a British breed of chicken and dual purpose breed. It's reared for both eggs and meat, but soon became exclusively a show bird. Their eggs are light brown. So let's get started with our very own incubation embryology project.
Today's day one, come look at my incubator.
All right, so today was setup day. We are incubating 7 chicken eggs and 3 duck eggs. Both of our incubators are set at 99.5 degrees. Our chicken eggs take 21 days and our duck eggs take 28. We use an incubator because it keeps our eggs safe and warm. It also turns them on a 3-degree angle so that every side of the egg is the same temperature. We're very excited to introduce these incubators to you because we will be launching them at our incubation embryology project for Orange County 4-H Spring 2021. See you guys soon.